Welcome back to Sim Casino Gameplay. My name is iSimulate. In my channel, I explore different simulation games and share gameplay videos of those I like. So if you're also a simulation game lover, make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any content. Okay, in today's video, we will talk about the major update released by the game recently on the 25th of March. So it took a longer period of time for this update to come out, but it really included a lot of topics, so I'm really excited to go through them together with you. And then, as promised last time, we will showcase the table games and sports betting. We will expand our casino at Riverside with these two area, sports betting and table games. And after that, we have basically completed the gambling part, all the gambling facilities. So let's do a wrap up on the gambling. Okay, so shall we start? You might have noticed already. So in this screen, this tutorials button is now clickable. That's one thing included in this update. Okay, let's see what we have in the tutorial. It's quite interesting. Instead, it's not a lot of text. Instead, you have different sections to explore, and you can read, and then you can also hover over a certain topic to learn more about it, like now. And you can also do some exercise, like okay, move the camera like this, and if you press shift, it's faster. Okay, cool. Turn the camera, like this. Okay, cool. Okay. I also quite like this startup casino they have prepared for us. Tilt the camera. Okay, like this. Okay, cool. You can continue to the next topic. You can skip it. You can go back to the tutorial and explore other parts of it. Building and decorating a successful casino, managing staff in crime, and controlling finances. So, if you like, you can go through all of them. That's cool. If we go back to the main menu, we can continue with the other updates. I have prepared another profile to go through at least two updates with you. Okay. So, and I think, it's very cool. You can see they have also improved this street view near the casino. So, that's very cool. Okay, so we are back at our casino at Riverside. I have let it run for one morning or half a day, but from midnight until noon. So now if you look at your P&L, you will see a electricity under your infrastructure category. So I think when I was playing this game before, I never worry about this expense. So it's a very realistic thing they have added here. And they have also mentioned by putting where is it? Oh, here. Okay, they have switched. Okay. Electricity. Oh, it's locked it now. It needs a we need to do a research. Okay. I remember from my previous gameplay, if you put solar panel above your roof, then it will help your electricity bill. Okay, but now I need to do a research, which I haven't, obviously. Then, we have to pay the bill, electricity. That's the second update. The third one is also a cool one. It's a ventilation. Let's go back to this menu. So we need air conditioner, air duct, the different kind of ventilation. These we can also put on the roof. I've never done that before because they didn't do anything, but now they have added in the game this system. So if you are in the middle of day and then you have more visitors in your casino, then it becomes warmer and they will demand ventilation facilities. So when it reaches a point, you will see this warning. Guessing your casino is too hot and will get slowly frustrated and thirsty. You need 4 more ventilation effect at peak heat times with current population. First time I do this, let's see what it does. So let's add this. I think the slot machine area is here. So reduces temperature of your casino during hot weather and busy hours. It's the same. Oh, these are way cheaper. Oh, okay. It consumes less electricity, so that's good. Air duct 5, ventilation effect 12, ventilation effect 16. Ventilation effect 21. Okay, this is the best actually. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, in the meantime, the warning has gone, so that's cool. Yeah, let's go back to our casino and let's get things going. Right, so the next update is regarding research. The screen has changed. It's very lucky for me, I have already completed the house advantage. It was called the big advantage research. Now you have to do more research, so not just one. So if the first time you do this, you get your house advantage maximum up to 12, and then next one it will bring it up to 15. And yeah, lucky me, I already did it, so my house advantage is already 18. But they have added this research progression in the game, so making it more challenging and more interesting. Okay, and then yeah, I was wondering about this. The next update is regarding the bed design. So I was sort of wondering why I didn't have a designer tool for the bed before. And then I saw in the game Discord that people share screenshots with nice colors for their hotel beds. So I was wondering. Yeah, now this is available. What I will do is, okay, yeah, this lady is sleeping. So let's surprise her with nice color of the headboard and the blanket. And yeah, I think this is good. Yeah, the bedsheet color. Okay, I think that's that will be the way I design my hotel room. Okay, now you also have a designer tool for the beds. That's cool. And one more topic regarding the update is on the staff scheduling. Yeah, to me there are like two types of staff. The first type is like the hotel, the retail. Then you go to a particular spot like this bar, and then you can decide on the schedule. So it is quite easily understandable. And the same for like the hotel reception. And there's another type of staff scheduling, like the housekeeping. They don't have a particular spot to operate. So here, like now for my, I only have one, oh, poor guy. Yeah, for this casino, I have one, so I want to increase it to two. Okay, so two staff here from 12 until 12 the next day. Do I have like a security guard? I only also have one, workman. Okay, now, so I have two staff here from midnight until 4. And then one from 4 to 9:30, two from for the rest of the day. So if I would like to have an extra shift, I can use this button. From 5 when the casino gets busier until 12. Yeah, that's it. I will have 3, for example. Confirm, then it will. Wow. No, 3. Did I say 5? Okay. Yeah, then it will look like this. Okay, I don't need this now, I think. Okay, so it will be back to original. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's all the updates I would like to talk to you about. Really cool. Especially the electricity thing and the ventilation. So that's something to take into account when expanding your casino. And then when you get more visitors, you have something more to take care of. So that's really cool. And then let's go to the building part. We will expand our casino with the table games and sports betting. Okay. We have been through another day of business at Riverside. So we did make profit, that's good. Again, yeah, most of the profit came from gambling. The business, we didn't make as much as the first day when the business facility started operating. But okay, yeah, let's hope when we have more visitors, it will grow. And then what we will be doing now is to expand the casino with more gambling options, the table games. And the sports betting. They will go to this part of the casino. So let's start building. Let's lay down the foundation. I just randomly laid it down. We may need more space or we may not. Okay, let me see. So how will the visitors get in? We need to demolish this. Move this somewhere else first. Okay, then okay, the visitors, they walk in, they enjoy the different slot machines, and when they need a break from slot machines, they can explore the other facilities, table games or sports betting. And the first thing is we need a cashier cage. Okay, let's put it here. I need to leave space for another one on the future. Okay, it's somewhere here. Let me mark it with a wall. Okay. We need a security guard to operate it. So the schedule will follow that of retail. Okay, so 10 o'clock this part of gambling, table games and betting, sports betting will open. Let's put the different table games on this side. Let's see. When you have a cashier cage, then you can see all these 7 table games are available. To have all of them available, one other prerequisite is this research table game rule editing. Otherwise, if I remember correctly, only some of the table games are available. So let's put one of each here. Okay, the red dot is where the staff will stand. Okay, we need more space. Let's give ourselves more space. Space. Okay. The last one. This is enough. Okay, cool. Let's put okay, the schedules first. It will follow that of the cashier cage. Let's copy. I think we can do a multi-select here. Can we paste schedule? Yes. Okay, let's check. Yeah, all of them are open at 10, which is good. And then the chairs. Chair. Let me check them. Yeah, they are the same type, right? Oh no, I have this one. Okay. No. This one and then this one. Okay, nice. Okay, multi select. Cool. Now we don't. Not all of them have chairs. Okay. I think that's for our table games. After you have this research completed, when you have table games in the casino, you can go to this manage gambling, and you will have the table game rules. Minimum players for the poker, the other things. I have to admit, I'm not. I don't really understand what this means. Not a gambling expert. But one thing I understand is the casino commission. So if somebody wins, you can also charge that person. Okay, part of your winning goes back to the casino, but that will have a negative impact on the player's frustration. So far, if I just leave everything as default, they seem to be working, so I will not touch them unless some experts explain to me how those things work. Okay, and then we need sports betting. Sports betting here. We need a betting window. Here people can place bet. It also has a schedule. It will follow that of the game. The opening hours of this area in the casino. Then we need the screen. Okay, and the TV. Okay, and then the betting booth. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then we need to mark this zone as a sports betting zone. But, let's do that after we have the flooring and walls done, which is quite easy because we will just follow that of the rest of the casino. So this part, the get one more, and then the carpet where the players will stay or sit will be carpet flooring. Yeah, like this. And then the table games. Okay, like this. Oh, okay, wait. Okay, cool. Yeah, and then I think I will build a bar here. Okay, sorry. Yeah, this part is also the stone flooring. Because I saw this bar is quite busy, so I think we need another one. Like this, like I think. That would be good, like this actually. Yeah, let's do this. No. Sorry, I think it's better like this. Okay. And then this tree. Go here. Polish some walls. And then they can make some space between these two. Will also be carpet beneath this bar. Okay. Nice. And the walls, same. Like the rest here. Do this. Okay. It's very dark. Yeah, I have the schedules done. Okay, and then we need some more couch for if people would like to take a break, would like to grab a drink, they can do that. I have the vending machine. Actually, vending machine. I think I need more. Before that, let's put an ATM here. Vending machine. Don't have space. Actually, yeah, I didn't do this. I've never done this before. Okay. Yeah, the trash bin. Yeah, okay. And I need a small table. Just to have something everywhere. Okay. More here. Trash bin. Ah, the schedule. Yeah, I also need the schedule. Okay. Yeah, because I used the eyedropper. Okay. And then I need to mark the sports betting zone. Sports betting. Sports betting. Let's see. Sorry, okay, otherwise I don't have exclamation marks, that's good. Okay, so yeah, I think we can start and see how this new facilities perform. Okay, now it's 10, 15, so you can see this part of our casino is open. We have trust staff at every table, and then also we have someone operating the betting window as well as the cashier cage. it's good people are coming into this area. And I just realized I actually spent quite some money on construction just to expand this part. Okay, I look back at the cost of each table games. Okay, they are not cheap, let's say. Okay, so the visitors, the gamblers, they can go to the cashier cage and then exchange coins, which they can use at the table games. So let's look at the table games. How are they doing? Okay, the poker, we have people there. Okay, now actually we have some players in most of the tables. Okay, roulette is still empty. From my experience, it's actually, I feel it's more difficult to have players at the Texas poker table because you need, like now, one player, the game cannot go on with just one player, and the minimum is two. It's how the game is, and also I think the it's related to your settings here. That's why I put it closer to the entrance of this area. Okay, so our second bar is doing quite well. It's quite busy. Let's look back at our first one. Okay, it's quite also quite busy. People like to grab a drink and chat, maybe. Sports betting is also quite busy. The betting booth, I feel like people are studying. Like here, it looks a bit like a library, but people are studying. Cool, let's fast forward and see how the first day of all these new extra betting facilities perform. Okay, the first day is the offer. Let's look at the finance. Okay, we made profit also yesterday, that's good. And don't forget how much money we spent on construction, 119. I didn't really pay attention when I built things, so okay, but we still record the profit, it was very good. And then, okay, let's look at the breakdown on the gambling. So yesterday, we had slot machines, oh, they made quite a lot of money yesterday. But we also had different table games. Some of them performed quite well, like they brought us 5,000. The roulette table, oh that's great, and all the table games they made more than they made in terms of thousands. Okay, the sports betting, okay, 141, but we actually had quite a number of gamblers in this area. I hope things improve going forward. The lifelong profit, okay, we didn't have profit, but the income so far within this zone is 351. And if we look at the, let's take this table, and we look, we can check the finance. So for this table, we didn't have any profit yet, but here you can see it made 8,000 income so far. The purchase cost is 10,000. Staff wages so far is 350. And then in the long run, so when you have it running for a couple of days, maybe you will see this table start making profit. And one more thing is the game settings. You can also set the minimum bet of each table. The default is 5, I didn't change it. So the players will need 10% confidence to start playing at the table. And also you can do a similar setting for the betting window. So again, the minimum bet is 5. Since this area has not been performing so well, I will lower it to 1. So let's hope more people will bet. After I lower it to 1, you can see the player gambling confidence required is reduced to 2%. And I haven't told you so far about the slot machines. In this casino, I set up 6 sets of slot machines, let's say. So some of them, they have $1 play cost. That will mean 2% player confidence. And I think I have these 2 sets. Yeah, the first 2 sets are $1 play cost. So when somebody walks in, he or she may not be that confident yet. They will try out, and then after, hopefully, they win, and then they can move on to the next. Our $2 play cost. I have 3 sets. So this set, these 2 rows, also $2, and this one. And when they are more confident, and they can have the $5 play cost slot machines, and this area. The table games, they all have $5 play cost minimum bet, so they will need 10% confidence. So, when the visitors come in, they work up their confidence, then they can go to this area and enjoy the table games. Yeah, let's hope more people bet at the sports betting zone. So that's the building part of sports betting as well as the table games. I hope you enjoyed it. There's one category of facilities we haven't talked about so far, which is the entertainment attractions. And that's the plan for our next video. We will be looking at the bingo hall, the theater, the gym facilities in our next episode. And they have made the game more challenging by getting these locked. I will need to do more research to unlock them. Okay, that's the plan. I hope you enjoyed this video as well as the game. If you have any suggestions, any questions, any tips I haven't figured out yet, please let me know. If you like the content, please give me a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. Have a good day and see you next time.